Howdy, partner. There's a new operating system in town, and it's called the NXOS, or Nexus Operating System. This is short for Next Generation. All right, I'm going to stop talking like that because I'm annoying even myself. Hi, everybody. Welcome to my micro nugget on the NXOS, our operating system for the modern data center, at least Cisco-centric data center. Let's jump in. What's so special about this next generation operating system? Well, if I were to sum it up in one word, I would have to say it's modular. Yeah, it is very, very modular. It's so modular that we can have a process, like let's say we have a BGP process running as a module inside the operating system. If that thing crashes, it won't crash the underlying operating system, and that particular process can gracefully restart, and it will have all of the state information that it possessed prior to the crash. This is because of a service called the Persistent Storage Service, or PSS, that is running inside the Nexus operating system. So I guess we should say high availability is another key element with this next generation operating system. Something else that's amazing about the NXOS now is that it is the unified operating system for both the LAN equipment of your data center and the SAN equipment. That's right. In the old days, it used to be the iOS that was running in the LAN, and the SAN had a SAN OS. Now these are unified thanks to NXOS 4.1 or higher. Once you get to 4.1 or higher of the NXOS, it can run on both your MDS equipment and it can run on like your Nexus 7000s and 5000s that you're going to have in the LAN equipment. So it's nice to have a single next generation operating system that we can trust in the data center. Now, in our CCNA data center and CCNP data center training classes here at CBT Nuggets, we run you through the paces of this next generation operating system. In this micro nugget, I thought I'd just give you a glimpse and show you some really cool features, and this is just a small slice of them, but just enough, I think, to get you excited. Let's jump in, roll up our sleeves, and log in to the NXOS. So here we are in a Nexus 7000 series. Now this is one of the switches that can do layer 3 routing and would be appropriate on the LAN side of your data center infrastructure. Notice that we have a pound sign after the name of my device. Ah, this is very iOS based, isn't it? And for those of you, and I'm sure it's most of my viewers today in this micro nugget, for those of you that are familiar with the iOS, you're going to feel right at home. For instance, we do a configure terminal and we can access global configuration mode. In fact, it's even easier than that. You can just say config and you will enter global configuration mode. So no longer the need to state the terminal. By the way, something else that I love about the Nexus operating system is the fact that like the PIX or the Adaptive Security Appliance operating system, we can issue whatever particular show commands that we would want in any mode, and we don't have to use the do command. So if I want to do a show VLAN brief while I am sitting right here in global configuration mode, that is not a problem whatsoever. Now, let me show you something extremely cool. Have you ever met someone that was really, really aggravated by a particular technology? In other words, they're very biased to one technology over another. I'm sure you've met someone in your life who really loved EIGRP and despised OSPF. Or maybe you met someone that loved OSPF and loves to poke fun at the EIGRP crowd. Well, in the Nexus environment, you can enable particular modules of the operating system based on your needs. For instance, if we despise EIGRP, we can literally scrub it from our operating system by saying no feature EIGRP. If we want EIGRP, we can go ahead and issue the feature EIGRP command to enable it. Think about the power of this. Think about you saving on resources by only enabling those particular NXOS features that you desire. Think about this from a security perspective. Yeah, if we eliminate EIGRP from the device, we just eliminated what we would call that particular attack surface. Sure, someone can't come in, enable EIGRP, and attack us using that particular facility. Something else that's really, really cool about the Nexus operating system is how they took care of role-based administrative controls, or RBAC. We know this used to be a nightmare in the past, right? Cisco did all kinds of stuff to try and give us role-based features. For instance, we remember the old privilege levels, easy for me to say, huh? The old privilege levels, and you remember what a nightmare those were in the iOS. So then Cisco tried to improve this, and they did what are called views, and we could create particular administrative views in the operating system. Well, they go a step further, and in my opinion, they really, really improve this whole process in the NXOS operating system. Watch this. I'll go ahead and create a username. So I'll say username John S. I'll create a user account, obviously, and I'll say password Cisco 123, and then watch this. Role. We can go ahead and issue the role keyword, and we can go ahead and make this person a full-blown network admin, or we can say, you know what, you're going to be a network operator. This John Smith user account now has just a limited set of basically show commands that they can issue as a network operator. They cannot make major configuration changes to the device. Notice we have a virtual device context administrator. Begging the question, what in the world is a virtual device context? Well, let me wrap up this particular micro nugget with a quick discussion of that. One of the great things that we can do with something like the Nexus 7000 series device, it's got such incredible horsepower, it's got such incredible resources, we can go in and we can create virtual Nexus 7Ks inside of it. So I could say this is a Nexus 7K A, and I could go in and create a Nexus 7K B. Sure enough, these will act as if they are independent Nexus 7000s. You can have your own admins in here. You can have your own admins in this context. You can be running BGP in here, completely separate and distinct from the BGP that you are running in here. You folks that are watching this particular micro nugget that are a bit long in the tooth, right? Like me, you're relatively old for this particular industry. You'll remember back to the monolithic mainframes, and you'll remember this was actually possible then. We could take our mainframes and we could partition them into virtual systems. We are certainly revisiting that with virtual device contexts in the Nexus operating system. Well, I certainly hope I've piqued your interest about the NXOS, and again, it receives very thorough coverage in CCNA Data Center and CCNP Data Center classes here at CBT Nuggets. I hope this has been informative for you, and I'd like to thank you for viewing.